Hey, what's up everybody? It's Dallas with Gadget Hacks, and today I'm going to show you how to move the status bar clock back to the right side on your Galaxy and Android Pi. Okay, so yes, this does require ADB, but don't let that scare you off. It's actually pretty easy and I'll walk you through the whole thing. For some background, Google moved the status bar clock from the right side to the left to accommodate phones with notches. Thing is, Galaxy phones don't have notches, but Samsung still incorporated the change in their One UI update. So it makes sense if you want to move it back. It's not really helping anything, except for maybe on the new Galaxy S10 line, plus it makes your notification icons a little harder to notice. But before we get started, understand that this only works on One UI, so you have to be using a Galaxy phone with the Android Pi update. If that's you, let's get started. First, you'll need to install an app called SystemUI Tuner from developer Zachary Wander. I'll post a link to this app in the description below, but if you just want to search for it, make sure system and UI are all one word. Once you've got it installed, don't even bother opening it yet. You'll need to give it elevated permissions using ADB, so let's get that set up first. On your computer now, start by downloading the latest ADB and Fastboot zip. This is a new standalone package, so it isn't the massive SDK toolkit that it used to be, just a quick file. There are three different links for this part, one for each major desktop OS. So go to the full tutorial using the link in the description below, then scroll down to step 2 and click the download link for Windows, Mac, or Linux. That should only take a few seconds, so open your download folder and find the zip you just grabbed. You can move it anywhere you want, but it's easiest if you just leave it in your download folder and extract it right there. The next big hurdle is getting a command prompt open to the right directory. So the first thing you want to do is copy the full path of the platform tools folder inside that extracted zip. If you're on Windows or Linux, all you gotta do is open the Platform Tools folder, then click the address bar up top and copy the location from there. If you're on Mac, you'll have to open the folder, press Command Option P to display the path name at the bottom of the Finder window, then right-click the Platform Tools part of that and choose Copy as Path Name. But with that path name copied, now it's time to open a command prompt or terminal window. If you're on Windows, you can do that by pressing the Windows key on your keyboard, then typing CMD and hitting Enter. If you're on Linux or Mac, just open the Terminal app from your Applications folder. Now type in CD, then a space, then paste in that path name you copied from the Platform Tools folder, and hit Enter. This gets the terminal operating in the right directory. It can now access those files you saw inside that zip you extracted, which means it can now run ADB commands. But before you get to that, you'll need to make sure your phone is ready to receive ADB commands. To do that, go to Settings, About Phone, Software Information, then tap Build Number 7 times in rapid succession. Now back out to the main Settings menu and head to Developer Options, which will be at the very bottom of the menu. In there, scroll through until you find USB Debugging, then turn the toggle on and press OK when prompted. At this point, connect your phone to your computer with a USB data cable. Almost right away, you should see a pop-up asking if you'd like to allow the computer to connect. Make sure to tick the box next to Always Allow, then press OK. If you're not seeing this pop-up, you might have driver issues. So head to the full tutorial on Gadget Hacks and check out the link at the bottom of step 3 for help with that part. Okay, so that was a bit of work, but the hard part's over with now. Back in that command prompt window, you'll just need to paste in a single command to grant elevated privileges to the SystemUI Tuner app. You can find this command in step 5 over at the full tutorial, so check out the link in the description. But I'll overlay it on the video here for a couple seconds if you'd rather type it in manually. So hit pause now. Once you get that copied though, just head over to that command prompt window and paste it in, then press enter on your keyboard. If you get an error like I just did, you're probably on Mac or Linux, or you might be using Windows PowerShell. Either way, the solution is to add a period and a slash to the very beginning of that same command. So dot, then slash, then just paste in that same command. No spaces between that slash and the command. This time when you hit enter, you shouldn't get an error. If you do, that guide linked out in step 3 of the full tutorial can help you get squared away. But now that you sent that command, the rest of the work can be done on the phone, so let's head back over there. Okay, so now you can open the SystemUI Tuner app. It'll make you wait to accept the terms and conditions, then it'll give you a little walkthrough. Tap the check mark on these screens to skip through it until you get to the blue Permissions screen. You'll notice it's asking you to send 2 other ADB commands to grant it even more additional permissions. By all means, feel free to do that. But these aren't required to move the clock. So for most people, I just say tap the check mark here, then hit yes, even though it says you're missing some permissions. The app will probably close out at that point, so you'll have to open it up from your app drawer again. Now we're at the easy part. Start by tapping to the tweaks, then on this main menu, hit Touch Wiz. Next, expand the miscellaneous menu, then hit clock position. Now if you watch closely, that stupid left justified clock instantly moves back to the right as soon as I select right in this menu. And yeah, it's really that easy once the app has the permissions it needs. You can move it back to the left or even center it from the same menu. So now your notification icons will start showing up in the leftmost corner again, your clock is back where it should be, and all is right in the world. But for more help with all the little things here, be sure to check out the full tutorial over on GadgetHacks.com. And as always, we'd appreciate it if you would like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel. So we'll see you again next time, folks. But until then, happy gadget hacking.